And Jamal, part of the reason this is complicated is because right now we are going through such a seismic cultural shift in how men and women relate to each other, how the gender roles work. So there is a sensitivity because we're trying to change.
Yeah, you're right, Jeff. You can't ignore this issue. I think this issue is a lot bigger than the game of Survivor. I've been listening very carefully to what everyone has said, and from my positionality with my gender, far be it from me to speak for women. What I can do as a man, I can give a little bit of advice as to how to hear these stories. When we're talking about harassment, when we're talking about discomfort, when we're talking about male entitlement, it behooves us all as men to take a step back and look at our own behavior and imagine that you had no idea that what you were doing was inappropriate, was making someone uncomfortable, and you believe women if they choose to bring that up, because it's difficult enough to do that in and of itself. We have a responsibility to hear women, listen to women, and believe women when they're ready to tell their stories.
Dan, let's just be clear. Was there a specific moment or incident, or is this just an accumulation of things that have been said?
Okay. Since it won't be let go, right, clearly, Jeff, right? It won't be
Dan,
let go.
You're right. I will never let it go. We'll be here until day 39.
Okay,
until,
so...
Just, Dan, slow down.
No.
You don't have to. Go ahead.
First of all, I work in the most high-wire industry in regards to this business. Most of my clients are women. Most of the people I work with are women. I work in an industry in which the Me Too movement was formed, in which it was allowed, thank God, to blossom, in which it was allowed to become powerful and strong. And my personal feeling is, if anyone ever felt for a second uncomfortable about anything I've ever done, I'm horrified about that, and I'm terribly sorry. And if that person was Kelly, if Kelly ever felt that in the freezing cold rain, or in tight shelters, or in walking around and saying, excuse me, hold on, I'm coming through, or in all the ways we have to crawl over and around and through each other in this game, I ever did anything even remotely that made her uncomfortable, it horrifies me, and I am terribly sorry. True, untrue, it doesn't matter what I feel, it doesn't matter whether I'm aware of it, it doesn't matter whether I ever sensed it. It doesn't matter whether I knew it happened or didn't happen. If someone feels it, it's their truth. I couldn't be more sorry. I couldn't be more confident in that I'm one of the kindest, gentlest people I know. I have a wife. I've been married for 21 years. I have two boys. I have a big business. I have lots of employees. And so I think what upset everybody here is that it somehow turned into gameplay.
Janet, how are you feeling right now?
Trying to decide if I should stay.
In the game?
All I ever wanted to do was play this game like everybody else. Never would I have wanted to create a problem with this platform. I feel the hatred. I feel so alone,
Janet,
for the last couple
hate
days.
You, Janet.
Janet, no one hates you. No one hates you.
Not in the least bit, Janet. I love you very much.
You should stay.
Nobody could feel that from their heart for you. Truly.
Truly.
Seriously.
Okay. Thank you.
Janet, wouldn't it be a shame to walk away? They've all told you didn't do anything wrong. Everyone here has a point of view. We're talking about it. We're addressing it. That's the most important thing.
Okay.
And now we go back into the game. That's why this is so complicated to play, but so compelling to be a part of.
Right.
So are you in?
I'm in.
Okay.